Now let's have a demo of parrot-rcc or robot framework bridge for Zeebe or Camunda 8. So parrot-rcc is a Zeebe worker for Camunda 8 or Zeebe that will run Robocorp RCC bots to execute the tasks for Zeebe or Camunda 8. RCC is Robocorp tool for executing small pieces of Python code or robot framework code with certain simple packaging that is to share and contains enough metadata for dependency of the task and the entry point of the task. Here we have simple Zeebe running locally, and here a simple process that has start, end, and simple task that will keep throwing the dice as long as the result is equal or more than 4. Let's deploy this process to Zeebe. Like that. Now we have our process here available. Then we get a few instances. All these instances will then stay and keep waiting for our throw of dice. So now we have 3 instances of this process running. Now we need to implement this task. So we open VS Code, and VS Code with Robocorp code extension that gives nice overlay layout for managing these bots. Here we have an example dice throwing robot that already has D3 D6 task for throwing the 6 dice. And the code is here. So this is robot framework task. It's simple, calls Python run in the library, and then uses Robocorp library for defining so-called opt work item. That is Robocorp way of define which variables are the ones that will come out of this task. And what is nice using this Robocorp convention is that we can run this task directly from Robocorp code. So now these tasks are running only locally and only using some example data on output data that we can view from the editor. So we can see that this throw directly resulted result 2. And if we do one more run, then we should get some other result. Let's see. So here we have result 2 and result is now 3. So with these tools, we can implement and try out these pieces of code right in IDE, which is nice. Next, we need to package this piece of code into the package recognized by RCC. For that, we use RCC robot wrap, and by default, it creates file robot.zip. And now this is something we can run with parrot-rcc. For that, we need a console. And here we have virtual environment with parrot-rcc installed. And we need simply launch parrot-rcc and then give it the path of any amount of path of the robot's zips to run. Now we have that our example robot there. We start and we see that it found our task D6 and already started running those. And now when we go back to Zeebe simple monitor, we should see almost all these already completed like this. So we had for 3 instances, we required 8 throws of dice to get all those processes up to 4 or more. To make this more interesting, let's add more dice throwing there. So let's make some room here. Let's make parallel dice throwing game here. So we have parallel gateway. Let's add an extra dice here. And then we want to merge this here also with parallel. So synchronize the process here. And now we only throw once to make it simpler. So it's a service task. I want to name it robot to get there. And this would be die D20. And task definition would be D20. Like this. And now we need to deploy this one. And version 2. And so we create a few instances. And now these instances should complete the first one, but then stay waiting for the second one. Second robot dies. Love it. But quite soon, all those have been completed. Now they are all waiting here. So now we should implement that D20 task. And well, let's make it easy. We just copy paste this code here. And it's in between 1 and 20. And let's make it another variable so that we overwrite the first one. Add the Zeebe. And often then we need to define the task here in the metadata. So its task is D20. And let's name it throw D20 in the robot file. And now we should be ready. We can already try it out here. Just run this D20 task and see it works. And it didn't work because I added typo here. So how nice was that to see it already here? Missing one number there. Now it worked and we have result 2 with 20 already. So we repackage this. Repackage this with RCC robot wrap like this. And then we restart our worker. And now it finds both of those tasks from that file. And they are already running in there like this. Now when we refresh Zeebe view, all the processes have been completed. So this is very convenient, the fast way to implement small glue code, small tasks, either in robot framework or in Python, in my opinion. The only downside is that running RCC adds a second or two, depending on the speed of the computer, for each execution. Or any slower and bigger, that should not be a problem.